Going on, everyone. Chris Manager bringing you guys a video today, and today I want to talk about, as the title of this video indicates, I think the best Warhammer 40k game. Now, I will preface this by saying my opinions are allowed to change in the future, and I am still a very limited amount of time in this game. I haven't played a ton of it yet, but yes, I think this is Darktide is the best Warhammer 40k game I've ever played, and let's dive into why I have this kind of insane opinion, especially as someone who has posted probably thousands of Dawn of War 2 videos at this point, which is within the Warhammer 40k universe. So, first off, the thing that I think makes this game stand out is the genre. And I know a lot of people, probably people who probably watch this video, will be like, what does the genre have to do with the game's popularity? A lot, actually. If you notice, like, some of the most popular games in the world, they tend to lean towards the first-person shooter genre. Games like Counter-Strike, Valorant, Rainbow Six Siege, Call of Duty, Battlefield, Halo, you know. Those last two aren't doing so well right now, but and when you look at this, this is because these games are so popular because they're easier to learn and understand. And I can see, I've seen this from both sides now that I've, again, working full-time and don't necessarily have a lot of time to devote to gaming. You see this from both sides. I don't want to work 8 hours a day and then come home and just be terrible at a fucking video game and get my ass beat for the next 3 hours and then go to bed. Like, that's 11 hours of misery in a day. That's too much for one person. Okay, and to do that repeatedly over and over. And so what I mean by that is, like, RTSs and MOBAs and all these kinds of games, they have very high skill ceilings. There's a lot to learn in those games, okay? There just is. There's a ton of stuff in MOBAs. You have all these different heroes and champions, and you have all these different skill builds and items and how and things interact with each other. They're very complicated. They're very intricate. And it's rewarding when you learn it all, but there's a very long learning curve. You're going to spend a lot of hours just learning what the hell they do. And then in RTSs, you have to a much lesser degree. Usually you don't have that many units available in a faction, but all these units have all these different uses and abilities. They all have different, you know, upgrades you can usually pick up or something like that, and situations that these units are viable. And the average person, I'm sorry, they just aren't going to want to learn all that. Okay, that's a lot. And so then you shift over to the first-person shooter side, and these games are super easy from a casual perspective. You know, you show Counter-Strike, I don't know if anyone's ever shown video games to their parents, but you show a game like Counter-Strike to, like, your dad or your grandma, and they'll be like, oh, I can understand. You know, after a few rounds, they're like, oh, I kind of understand what's going on here. You know, like, you get money for killing them, and the one team's trying to plant the bomb, you know, the other team's trying to stop them. It's pretty straightforward. And I think that Darktide is going to play off of that as well. And I hope that this game does really, really well, because I love this. I still love the Warhammer 40k, you know, IP. I think it's unbelievable. And I think this will probably be the best game in terms of sales or reviews or whatever, at least until Space Marine 2. We'll see how Space Marine 2 does whenever that comes out. I think it's coming out next year. I don't know. But yeah, a lot of it has to do just with the genre of game this is in, right? Unfortunately. I mean, I know it's, I love RTSs. I love MOBAs. They're great genres of games. They're so much fun. I like learning a lot, but I can see the other side of it now, where it's like, goddamn, would I really want to invest, you know, a couple hundred hours learning into a new game again? And in these games, that's not to say there's nothing to learn in these games as well, right? There are intricate details. There are little things that you can learn and stuff like that, but you'll learn them, it seems like, quicker. Next, I want to talk about just how good of a game Darktide itself is, absent of the genre. Holy shit, this game is, it is a ton of fun to play this game. The environment is unbelievably good looking. I think I'm playing on, like, medium here with no ray tracing on. The frame rate is much better, although I still get really bad frame drops. I'm gonna blame that on my rapidly aging computer at this point now, which is still a good computer, but it's insane that games are just beating my computer's ass now. It looks so good. The combat feels very good. The shooting, actually, which was kind of my main concern, because when you look at a game like this, you're like, okay, it's a mix of Vermintide, and I don't know how Vermintide, I didn't play much Vermintide. I played through the games, but I didn't actually, like, invest a lot of time into them. So my concern was, oh, the ranged combat's probably going to be dog shit, and the melee combat's probably going to be pretty good. No, actually, they're both pretty good. The ranged combat feels solid. Melee combat feels great. There's tons of different fucking items you can buy and pick up and stuff. The maps are... I have to keep saying this. The maps are unbelievably good. Okay, like, these maps are so satisfying. It's just good to play this. It feels good to play the game. You know, it feels fun. The classes have their own unique abilities. They all have their own skill trees that you can level up through and stuff. It's a good time. And that's more than you could say for most Warhammer 40k games. As a story, it's not... I don't even really know what the story's about. Look at that guy. Holy shit. He's got absolutely annihilated. So I think the other... I see longevity, you know, because this is going to be a live service game. They're going to have microtransactions, which I know people are going to be up in arms about, you know, but that's fine, guys. Like, it's... You kind of have to adapt to the current, you know. You can sit there and complain about games having microtransactions, but, you know, people have always wanted to customize their skins, and as long as they keep those microtransactions, you know, not pay to win, I'm good with it. Hey, listen, let me put a cool ass skin on this axe, okay? I want it to look like a... Let's put some flame on it or something, you know? I pay $5 for that. I wouldn't pay $5 for it, you know, but, like, a few bucks for it here or there. So the gameplay, like, look at this. Look at this. Look at what I am looking at here. Now, this is shitty because, you know, it's knocked down because of YouTube's fucking... or Twitch's compression, and then I'm recording the recording, and that's gonna get knocked down even further. But when you play this game, it just looks unbelievable. And keep in mind, again, this is on medium, okay? We're not cranking high frames here. Looks so good. It feels so good. There's a lot of technical issues right now that other people are having. I mentioned the frame drops earlier. A lot of people are having bad server disconnect issues and stuff. I trust that they're gonna get those fixed. And I know that it seems, having kind of looked at the public perception, that the general perception is pretty popular towards this game right now. But obviously you've got... It seems like the people who are actually most upset are the Vermintide 2 fans who have been playing thousands of hours of that game. They seem to be the people who are really just most angry with this. I don't get it, but I also didn't invest my time in that community. So what else makes this the best game? I'm trying to sit here and think. I mean, you have all different classes. There's a lot of game time you can get here. I mean, missions run 20 to 30 minutes, depending on the crew you're running with. I guess another downside would be the lack of mission variety, it seems. But even those rotate out, so, like, let's say you get a class of mission. There's one mission where you have to, like, scan things. I hate those missions. So, like, I could just play another mission and then wait a little bit, and that mission will rotate out, and then you can pick up another one. So, like, even the negatives, like, of me and not enjoying a specific type of mission, it's like, well, I could just wait, like, a couple minutes, or just do another type of mission at a different difficulty level. Or there's several different missions, they're always rotating in and out. So there's a shop. Apparently the shop is RNG, which a lot of people are hating right now because they're not getting class specific weapons and stuff, which makes sense. I can understand the frustration there. However, once again, it's literally a matter of maybe just log off for like a day or check it, and then if you don't get to what you want, then just, you know. I mean, like, I hate to sit here and be like that guy, right, who's like just shitting on the hardcore fans, but like, it really is. I don't think this is a game that you're gonna invest tens of thousands of hours into. I do think this is still the game that you can invest thousands of hours into and have a very good experience playing. Tons of different, like, four different characters to level up. Like I said, you have the skill trees, which have all different kinds of builds and combinations of builds and stuff that you can go on. I think this game's going to do really well, and I look forward to seeing this game hopefully do well, and hopefully that propels the Warhammer 40k IP. Even if you don't like this game, and you like the IP, even if you're a Dawn of War fan or whatever, you should still be rooting for this game, because if this game does well, you're going to see more Warhammer 40k games and more people pay attention to this universe. And my god, okay, I don't even know a lot about the Warhammer 40k universe, but I know there's a lot of shit in it, okay, and there's a lot of potential for some really awesome stories to be told that just haven't been told yet. And yeah, very much looking forward to it. Let me know what you guys think if you've played Darktide 2. Jeez, hold on, let's play the first one here. Let me know if you played Darktide. Let me know what your thoughts on it are, if you've played other games, or maybe if you hate Warhammer 40k and you're playing it over, you're a diehard, you know, and you're loving it or whatever. There seems to be a lot of minor details that they've really... One other thing, God, I really want to put in here. So the Warhammer 40k seems to be like really big on like suppression and your character being suppressed and you know, stuff like that, even carried over into the RTSs and stuff. I love the way they fucking put it in this game, okay? Like, you can get suppressed in this game and your aim goes really wonky and like your screen starts blurring up on the sides. It's like, it's such a cool nod to me, to like the other, to remaining faithful to like, okay, this is, why do these games have this, right? And it seems to be like a pretty unique Warhammer 40k, not unique in the sense of like they're the only games that have it, but it seems to be like a hallmark, right? And like most Warhammer 40k games, you've got suppression mechanics and things that are in the game. And the fact that they put it in this game, in the manner that they put it in, it feels so right. You know, it's like, yes. Another hallmark is, you know, units switching from range to melee combat and the blend between the two. You know, in Dawn of War 2, it was very, very common to use ranged units in melee to tie up other units who were maybe worse in melee, even though both units could be bad in melee. You know, if one unit is better than the other, you would go ahead and do that. And you do the same thing here in this game. And I'm sure there's going to be probably a bunch of moments where I'm fucking raging the shit at this game. And I might make videos on that when I do that. But you know what? Just know this right now. I think this has the potential to be the best Warhammer 40k game. I think it probably is right now, to be honest. And I think it's only going to get better collectively. There's going to be ups and downs. There's going to be bumps in the road. But I think the graph is going to continually and gradually go up. And I'm excited to see where they take the future of this game. And I'm excited to see where other companies... if we start paying a little bit more attention to this universe, because, boy, we hit a real low point with Dawn of War 3. Okay, that's not a good time. All right, thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Oh, peace.